Hello friends and welcome back. So today's video we are going to see about engineering materials, how these engineering materials are used in analysis. Let's get started. First of all, we will see why we need information of engineering materials. So basically, this is the important step where we need these two steps, which is to be carried out first. Selection of a material is the first step in the designing. So while designing any product, any part, we have to select the material first. Like designing a shaft, we need to select the material first. Now in second step, engineering data is the first step in the FEA. If we are carrying out some FEA analysis using some software, so we need to enter the data of the materials, that is engineering data. So we will see. So basically, materials are called as engineering materials because the applications we use in the engineering, the materials required for those applications is called as engineering materials. It is basically classified into following types: metals, polymers, composites and the ceramics. But 80% of the structures made up of these metals. So metals are most important engineering material. Now we will see how the properties of a material are used in these steps. So engineering material is basically classified on the basis of this stress strain curve. Means stress versus strain is plotted and we will get some curve. So this is universal testing machine which used to calculate these graphs for each metal we use in the engineering applications. So let's understand. So this is the first graph, where this is a straight line, it is a linear line. So a material which is behaving in this region is a linear, means as stress increases, strain will also increase. But at some point, it will start behaving as a plastic, that is an engineering yield point. From this yield point, it will behave plastically. So as the stress increases, deformation will increase more, and after this point, maximum stress point, without applying any force, it will deform and it will break here. So most of the applications we use in the engineering, we limit our stress up to some region, so that it will not go beyond yield point. So there will not be any plastic deformation. Slope of this line is called as a Young's modulus, E. So it is the ratio of stress divided by strain. So we use the material so that maximum stress will not cross beyond this line. So this is the criteria which is defined by von Mises stresses. Now, while using this material in analysis, we put values of Young's modulus and value of Poisson's ratio. Density rho is not compulsory constant which is to be used, because it is used to calculate the weight of the product, which not takes in account of the stress calculation. So we will give these two values. So from these two values, this is the slope, we will get stress strain curve like this. So this is stress and here it is a strain. So we will get a linear graph. So when we apply force, we will get some deformation. So this calculation will be done by the ANSYS software. Now, after this yield point, suppose this is a yield point, so it is going beyond, means this line is continuously a straight line, linear line. So if we apply the maximum stress, it will give some deformation. But in actual practice, if we apply maximum stress, it will give different deformation. So linear analysis will be very good if we carry out beyond this yield point. After that, it is not possible to get the correct result. For this, we have one tangent modulus. This is a TM, that is a tangent modulus. So this is the point where we will give yield point. So this is the yield stress here, and from that, this, instead of going linearly, it will go in this direction. So this tangent modulus slope will help to create one graph, so that it will use Young's modulus first. From this yield point, it will use tangent modulus. So somewhat we will get one curve which is linear, and again it will be linear. So these are the two linear lines. So it is called as a bilinear material. So this is a linear material, this is a bilinear material, but giving all the points here is not possible. Means in virtual analysis, we need to give these points so that we will get an actual graph. So if we see, there is number of points, so this is a multilinear graph. So in between these two lines, there is a linear line. So we need to create a multilinear material so that it will give actual behavior of the analysis. So this is the materials we use, how we use in ANSYS, and this is the actual material of the stress strain graph. Now here in this linear analysis, we use two constants. Now we will see how many constants are required to define a material. So the metals are the isotropic material, means properties of this metal are same in all direction, in xy plane, yz plane and zx plane. So we need only two elastic constants, that is E and the Poisson's ratio. So remaining constant will be calculated from these two values. Now if we see orthotropic material with the transverse isotropy, means there are three planes in which one plane having similar properties of the other plane. So we need five constants here. So there are similar properties in one plane, but in other two planes it is not similar. So we need five constants, especially orthotropic material. Here our material is not similar in three planes, so we need 9 constants. But in each plane, this material properties are similar. Now monoclinic material, only in one plane material properties are same, in other two planes these material properties are not same, so we need 13 constants. Then in anisotropic material, in no plane there will be similar properties, so we need minimum 21 elastic constant to define this material. Apart from this, actually we need 81 constants, but due to the symmetry of a stiffness matrix, we can calculate those constants. So maximum we need is a 21 constant. So these constants are like Young's modulus in X, Young's modulus in Y direction, Young's modulus in a Z direction, similarly Poisson's ratio in these different directions. Similarly, there will be shear stress or modulus of rigidity we need in the different directions. Likewise, these constants are counted in this region. So we have understood about the materials and the material constant today. Thank you.